Are you ready to grow your channel to your first 1,000 subscribers? Well, you've come to the right place. Today, I'm gonna share with you my 5 strategies for getting there. Hey, welcome back to my channel. My name is Katie Steckley, and here I love to talk all things YouTube, Instagram, filmmaking, and freelance. Make sure that you hit that subscribe button so that you don't miss any of my future videos. I upload every Sunday, Tuesday, and Friday. A lot of you seem to really enjoy my video from Tuesday that was all about how to get your first 1,000 followers on Instagram, and some of you requested that I make the same video, but for YouTube this time. Since I just recently hit 10,000 subscribers and I'm continuing to grow, I'm super excited to bring you the strategies that I have used over the past couple of years to gain subscribers, and I think that they are gonna be specifically useful for those of you out there that have recently started a channel and are trying to hit your first 1,000. So let's dive in. The first step to success is starting your channel with purpose. Some people might call this choosing a niche. Some people might call this having a mission or a vision for what you're gonna create. But the important thing is that you have some clarity on exactly what your YouTube channel is gonna be and who it's gonna be for. If potential subscribers come to your channel and they aren't really sure what kind of content you're making or who it's targeted at, they're less likely to subscribe because they won't have a sense of whether or not it's for them. So as you're starting your channel, make sure that you come up with a niche. If you wanna watch my video about how to figure out what that is, click on it up here. But basically what you need to decide is what your passion is gonna be for this channel and therefore what content you're gonna create. Once you have that figured out, it's time to commit. Now I'm serious about this. If you really want to grow, you need to commit yourself to making videos at least once a week, probably more often. Now, I know that might sound intimidating going from 0 to once a week, 0 to 52 videos a year, but when you set your mind to it and when you create a schedule that's very practical with steps that you need to take to get there, I promise you, you can do it. When I was in university and I was a residence don taking 6 courses and just in general a very busy university student, I still managed to upload 5 videos a week because I got myself out of bed every day at 6 a.m. to edit the previous day's video and upload it. Obviously, you don't need to do 5 videos a week, but that just goes to show how much you can fit it into your schedule if you're really passionate about it. So just try to figure out where is there time in your day where maybe you can cut out a Netflix show here, some mindless scrolling on Instagram there, and put together like 2, maybe 3 hours a week max to film, edit, and upload your video. It's really important that you commit to this schedule because if you don't, you're definitely not going to grow very quickly because it is important that you have some kind of consistency or else people aren't going to see a reason to subscribe. Even if one of your videos does happen to get picked up in the algorithm, if somebody comes to your channel and see that you haven't posted in like a month or two, then why would they bother subscribing? Because they probably won't see anything new from you. So it's important to stay consistent at least once a week. Now, before you go ahead and launch your channel, if you haven't already, I would recommend creating and uploading 3 to 4 videos that are going to be really representative of the kind of content that you plan to continue to create. This way, when potential subscribers show up at your channel and they see what kind of videos you've already made, they have a better sense of what you'll be making in the future. Once you have that ready, plus a channel banner and all that other fun stuff, it's time to share it on your existing social media channels. Now, you might not have a ton of followers other places, but I'm sure that you do have some friends and family that would be willing to go and hit the subscribe button so you can get your first 10 to 20 subscribers. It's really important at this point that you go in with confidence and be bold, because if you're super shy about it and you don't want to tell your friends and family that you're making a YouTube channel, that is going to be the first step of not getting this off the ground. I know it's really hard and it can feel really awkward, but the people that you know in real life are gonna be your best supporters at first to get you some subscribers and get you some views as you're getting started. So send out an email to everybody you know, post it on Facebook, even though I know that can be scary for some of you. Post about it on Instagram, Twitter, wherever you have any kind of connections. Tell people about your YouTube channel and they will go there, see those 3 to 4 videos that you've already made, and then be able to decide if they're gonna be interested in what you're creating. Going forward, as you create more videos week to week, it's important that you make sure those videos are searchable and topical and have clickable titles and thumbnails. That is the formula for getting somebody to subscribe. If your content is searchable so that it can be found, it's clickable so that it entices somebody to watch it, and finally, it's valuable so that the person who has actually taken time out to watch that video feels rewarded from doing so, that is what is going to create for you a satisfied viewer. Once you have a satisfied viewer, you need to combine that with some bingeable content and the topic they are interested in, and that is what is going to bring you a subscriber. All of that working together with the algorithm, with search results, with a foundation of good content that people are going to be interested in, that is the cycle that is going to bring in new subscribers to your channel. And that is what you are trying to set up here as you keep making videos in your niche and make sure that they are searchable, clickable, and valuable. That's what's going to bring you a subscriber. Finally, I just want to emphasize the importance of that content being valuable. There is so much stuff out there on YouTube that has these flashy thumbnails, big promises in the title, which is great. Like, it gets you to click on it. But if you show up there and then the person who promised you Instagram hacks is just showing you that you can tap through a story to skip a long video, you're going to be kind of disappointed and feel like that's not really what you clicked on the video for. So you're probably just gonna click away and leave and definitely not subscribe to that person. The same principle has to apply to the content that you are making. So make sure that your own content measures up to the standards that you have for other people and ensure that whatever you're putting out there, when people come and watch it, they're actually satisfied with it. The trouble with YouTube is that you really do need to prioritize both quantity and quality. It really can't be an either or. You need to be creating valuable videos that hit it out of the park every time, and you need to be doing that on a weekly basis. So I'm not gonna lie, it's hard. It is difficult to allot that much time in your schedule to create the content that people are gonna find valuable and doing that on a regular basis, but that is the formula for growth. That is why not everybody does it. If there was some secret trick or formula that you could watch in a YouTube video to make you famous, everybody would be. But it actually just takes a lot of time, a lot of hard work, patience, and a little bit of luck to get there. But if you follow these 5 strategies that I provided, I can assure you that it's gonna go a lot faster for you than it did for me. So those are my tips. I really hope that you found it helpful. Once again, if you're having trouble picking a niche, check out this video that I made because I think you'll find it helpful. It's a really practical step-by-step way of figuring out what your channel should be about. But before you go watch that, please hit the subscribe button. I would really appreciate it. I upload every Sunday, Tuesday, and Friday valuable videos just like this. As always, I hope that you are having adventures and following your dreams, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!